What is 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1, and so on forever? Here are the answers of 88 high school students, which highlight debates mathematicians were having a few centuries ago. Let's explore the sum in 5 levels, ranging from arithmetic and algebra to calculus and beyond. For the first level, we might try to cancel out some of these values. The first two numbers are plus 1 and minus 1, which cancel out to 0. Then the next pair also cancels out to give 0, and so on and so on. So it seems like this sum should equal 0. But there's a problem here. What if we pair off the values a little differently? Let's cancel the second and the third terms this time. Minus 1 plus 1 equals 0. Then the next two terms should cancel out to 0, and so on. This time, we have a 1 left over. So does the sum equal 0 or 1? It gets even weirder. This time, let's try to save the first and the third terms. We can cancel out the second term and the fifth term, minus 1 plus 1 equals 0, and then the fourth term will cancel out with the seventh term, and so on. The pairs are a little farther apart now, but we've paired up all the terms except for those two ones. Now it looks like the sum should be 2. We can pair off the terms differently to get the answer as 3, or negative 1, or all sorts of other values. So we might think that this sum is not defined, since it seems like we can get all sorts of different answers. We'll need some more advanced tools to be able to fully solve this problem. For level 2, let's think algebraically. Let's call this sum S. S equals 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1, and so on. Let's write this as 1 minus, and then factor out that negative sign. This will switch each minus to be a plus, and each plus to be a minus. The part that we're subtracting is exactly the same sum that we started with. This is the same as S. So we now have the equation S equals 1 minus S. Now we can solve for S. Add S to the other side to get 2S equals 1, and S equals 1 half. So we have yet another possible answer for this sum. We can also get this answer another way. This is a geometric series, since each term is found by multiplying the previous term by negative 1. The geometric series formula tells us that a geometric series equals A over 1 minus R, where A is the first term and R is the common ratio that we multiply by to get to the next term. This series formula only holds when the absolute value of R is less than 1. In this case, R is negative 1, so the formula doesn't apply. But what if we plug it in anyway? We would get 1 over 1 minus negative 1. The two negatives cancel out and we get 1 half. Several centuries ago, before calculus was made rigorous, this was a source of intense debate between mathematicians. Is this series undefined, or does it equal 1 half? For level 3, let's look at the calculus solution. To find an infinite series like this, we look at the partial sums. The first partial sum is just the number 1. The second partial sum we get by adding up the first two numbers. 1 minus 1 is 0. And then the next partial sum, we add up the first three terms. 1 minus 1 plus 1 is 1, and so on. In calculus and modern math in general, we define the infinite series to be the limit of its partial sums. If the infinite series adds up to a value, then the partial sums should be getting closer and closer to that value. But in this case, the partial sums keep bouncing between 0 and 1. They never settle on any one specific value. So we say that this series diverges, and that the sum is not defined. So we have our rigorous answer. This series diverges. But mathematicians have found various ways of assigning values to certain divergent series like this one. For level 4, let's think again about the partial sums. These partial sums don't converge to any one specific value, but they do have some pretty nice structure. Half the time they're 0 and half the time they're 1. So maybe it is reasonable to assign the value of 1 half for this series. Ernesto Cesàro defined this approach, which is called Cesàro summation. Instead of looking at the limits of the partial sums, let's look at their averages. First, we take the average of the first partial sum, that's just 1. Next, we take the average of the first two partial sums. The average of 1 and 0 is 1 half. Next is the average of 1, 0, and 1. We add those up and divide by 3, getting that the average is 2/3. Next, we take the average of the first four partial sums, and so on. What's happening to these averages? They're approaching 1 half. This makes sense for Cesàro's probabilistic approach, since half the time the partial sum is 0 and half the time it's 1. So this series is divergent, but we can use Cesàro's technique to get that the Cesàro sum of the series is 1 half. Cesàro summation allows us to get values for certain divergent series, and it's also proven extremely useful in the field of probability. Cesàro sums actually played an important role in my thesis research. For level 5, let's look at another summation method that can be applied to certain divergent series. This is called Abel's method. We convert our series to be a power series. The 1 will stay a 1, and then the negative 1 will become negative 1x. The next term is plus 1, which becomes plus 1x squared, and then we'll have negative x cubed, positive x to the fourth, and so on. The power series is different than our original series, but the idea is if x is equal to 1, then all those x's go away and we're right back to the original series. Since the original series is divergent, we don't want to just plug in x equals 1. So instead, we'll let x be between 0 and 1, and then we'll take the limit as x approaches 1. This power series is a geometric series, since to go from one term to the next, we multiply by negative x. X is strictly between 0 and 1, so we can apply the geometric series formula. The first term is 1, and the common ratio r equals negative x. So we get 1 over 1 minus negative x, which equals 1 over 1 plus x. Then we take the limit as x approaches 1. This function is continuous there, so we can just plug in x equals 1 to get 1 half. The Abel summation agrees with the Cesàro summation and gives the value as 1 half. Now we have a pretty complete picture of this series. It diverges since the partial sums don't converge, so the sum does not exist. But we can find the Cesàro summation or the Abel summation, which are both equal to 1 half. Can you find the Cesàro summation for this divergent series? Let us know what you find in the comments and subscribe for more videos like this one. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.